scissors, a bunch of knives, and a grill cleaner for $12. You see, this could be a part of the problem right there, but that could be intended design. Some of the shielding's kind of pulled away from it. The rest of it looks like it's actually bent into it. I don't know if that's intended or what. It's hard to tell. Because some of the solder actually melted down into it. Holy crap! Part of the pad came with this guy. A little bit came with that one. Looks like this thing literally got welded. Obviously, we can see which one's bad, which one's not bad. This part is slightly different in terms of the internal shielding. Width is the same. Position of the pins is the same. It looks to be the same. In fact, this one looks to be high quality. It does have all the shielding on it. Figure out what that Seahorse company is. So I can order these things for myself and sell them. Because I'm tired of paying $38 for jacks, laptop jacks. Don't get me wrong, I mean, it's not a horrible price, but if I can get them cheaper, I will. That looks clean. Let me use my desoldering braid to clean out. This some. Yeah, sells me a knife set and a grill cleaner. And you see what I need the scissors for? Cutting soldering braid, desoldering braid. That's all I needed. Pair of scissors for. And honestly, if I didn't need it, I would have told him to piss off. Get the hell out of my store. Or I would have probably just suckered him along some like I usually do these vendors that walk in. It's pretty good at cutting copper. They're of poor construction quality. What do you expect for $12, you know? The bad thing is, they just walk right up in here. Just think that they can sell you stuff. And my neighbors here must be getting pretty ticked off, because we kind of entertain the solicitors that come in here. Like, oh yeah, we're here to buy this, do this. We can hook you up with this great deal, yada, yada, yada. And what do? I jerk them around. Make them think that they can get me to buy something. Usually can't. You screw around with them. Just to screw around with them. And that's one of those things I'm hoping to catch on the live cameras once I get them going. A little bit more. I mean, obviously you see the current live camera on me, but... because yes, this is streaming live. Live streaming Broadbrain. So I guess I should try and make this a little bit more interesting. This is kind of a boring topic. I don't think I'm going to do another desoldering thing again, unless it's just me desoldering and going over stuff at the same time. But tell me what you think. It's only 3 hours into this. If you're still watching, you're probably a better man than I am. Or you really, really, really want to learn about doing a laptop solder joint. Wow, this is his problem right there. That is a bad pad. I only hope that when I solder this thing back on, it's going to help take care of that. I have to solder it on the back as well. Noticed how horrifically deformed it is. So we got this here. Got our desoldering braid. Good to go. And basically, by wanting to learn how to do this stuff, definitely recommend doing some soldering projects beforehand. If you've already taken apart your laptop, you've never soldered before, oh boy, are you in some trouble. But yeah, definitely desolder some before you start doing this. Prevent yourself from getting into some serious trouble. Practice, build a few timers, little Radio Shack projects, those kind of things. Just try pushing this stuff down first.